Heavy rains, tornadoes, flooding. Here in Pinellas County, we typically think of these effects during hurricane season. But they can also happen because of the El Niño phenomenon. The National Weather Service is predicting a wetter and colder than normal winter and spring due to El Niño. What is El Niño? What does it mean to you? Will your home and family be at risk?
Hello and welcome to this special edition of Prepare to Survive. I'm Libby Bowling with Pinellas County Communications. Joining me to talk about the El Niño phenomenon and what you can do to prepare for the possibility of extreme weather is Sally Bishop, Director of Pinellas County Emergency Management. Thanks for joining us, Sally.
Thank you, Libby.
And Dan Noah, Warning Coordination Meteorologist with the National Weather Service in Ruskin. Thanks for joining us, Dan.
My pleasure, Libby.
What is El Niño?
You can think of El Niño as warmer than normal temperatures in the tropical Pacific. It's only 2 or 3 degrees, but we're talking about a bathtub that's 5,000 miles long, 1,000 miles wide, and 500 feet deep. So that's a lot of excess energy in the ocean that is going to be released into the atmosphere.
And is it along the equator? Is that where it is?
It is along the equator, and that warm water changes where the thunderstorms form. Mm-hmm. And you get all that energy going up into the upper atmosphere, and that changes where the upper level jet stream is going. Mm-hmm. And that's just a fast moving river of air about 30,000 feet off the ground. Normally for Florida, it's well north of us, and we have Chamber of Commerce weather. But this year is going to be different. El Niño is going to take that jet stream, and it's going to flow across northern Mexico, right across central Florida. And that's our concern because that can help develop violent tornadoes.
So, violent tornadoes, more rainfall, heavier rainfall. Can you describe what we may?
Back in 97, 98 was the last time we had an El Niño this strong, and we ended up with our deadliest tornado in Florida, 42 fatalities in Kissimmee in February of 98. We had record rainfall, river flooding, area-wide flooding, and we had all that growth of green pop up over the dry season, and then we went right into a drought. And all that green stuff dried up and caught on fire, and we closed Interstate 4 for multiple days.
Oh my goodness. So we hope that doesn't happen. But the best thing is to be prepared and understand what the possibilities are.
The biggest effect is from January through April. So that's about 120 days. During that time period, there might be 7 or so outbreaks. And by outbreak, I mean, 60 reports of damage and $100 million worth of damage. And it usually is at night, which is our biggest concern, between 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. are when most of the fatalities occur in these tornadoes.
Mm. Well, Sally, I know that we are very concerned about the possibility of these heavier than normal weather impacts here in Pinellas County. And emergency management is preparing like you do every day, isn't it?
Absolutely. So the basic hazards that we're looking at are the heavy rainfall, which could cause flooding, and then the severe weather, which could cause tornadoes. So we're focused on those hazards and making sure that we're prepared for those hazards and that our partner agencies and our city partners are aware that this is an elevated threat for this season so that everybody's on the same sheet of music as far as we've got our plans in order, we're aware of what the possibilities are that are coming. Besides that, we're doing a very large campaign, this being part of it, to make sure that our general population knows that they need to not relax just because it's not hurricane season this year. So that kit that they keep all year long during hurricane season needs to be refreshed, and we're suggesting that they add some items to it. So they can expect to see a lot of media releases, news releases, social media posts, our web. Has been updated, our webpage has been updated, all of the things that we can do to make sure that we've got the word out so citizens are aware that they need to be prepared from January through April for a very active weather, the possibility of a very active weather season.
And part of that is the Weather Ready Nation that is with the National Weather Service and NOAA. Can you tell me about that partnership?
Absolutely. After Hurricane Sandy, sociologists did a study and they said okay, Weather Service, you told all these people to prepare, and a lot of people didn't because they don't know you. So they said, recruit ambassadors. So we're looking for ambassadors for a weather-ready nation. Somebody in your organization that likes weather, whether it's in your HOA or church, they can sign up to be an ambassador. And then every so often they'll get an email, a preparedness email that they can share with the people around them and help them to get prepared.
Mm-hmm. And Pinellas County is a partner, is an ambassador with this program.
We certainly are. And actually, Dan, just one of the other things that the timing happened to be fabulous on is we just had the largest weather spotter class, which is another thing that citizens can get involved in, is become weather spotters. And then also sign up to become weather ambassadors as part of that so that they spread the word throughout the community.
Mm-hmm. So for personal preparedness, what do we tell people? We tell them year-round about this, don't we?
Right, right. And so our all-hazard guide and our website has that general checklist of items to have. So we always suggest that they have that. But in particular, for this particular El Nino event, we want them to think about either A, weather alert radio, and or B, signing up to one of the applications that provides weather alerts. Mm-hmm. And they may already be getting wireless emergency alerts through their cell phones if their phones are new within the last couple of years. So if they get amber alerts, they'll get the weather alerts that way also. But the beauty of the weather alert radios is they provide a redundancy to the fact that phone lines get jammed. So you may not get something through on email or text messaging in as timely a manner. And thanks to Dan's great information, our average warning time for tornadoes is only 13 minutes. So that's not a lot of time to get the warning and then be able to react, mm-hmm. especially if it's at night and people are asleep. And that's why I actually have a weather radio next to my bed, because I want to make sure that I get woke up in order to be aware of the fact that there's a tornado warning.
Right, right. And so also Alert Pinellas notification system, people can sign up for that on our website under the emergency management website.
Sure, and that the beauty of that is that that's used for any type of an emergency. So if they go to our website and click on the link to go sign up for Alert Pinellas, we use that for any type of an event that we need to communicate with the citizens. There's also an option when they do sign up online to say, yes, I want to receive alerts for severe weather warnings. So it'll be another way to get texted or emailed or whatever your choices are and what devices you put in to get notified of severe weather warnings. Mm-hmm.
All right. Final words for our viewers.
These tornadoes aren't going to be like our summer tornadoes. They're going to be a quarter mile wide and on the ground for 20 miles or more. So if one happened to come across Pinellas County, it could go across the entire county. Mm-hmm. If you live in a manufactured home, think now about what you're going to do if we're expecting a night of tornadoes.
All right. And Sally, any other last minute advice for our citizens?
I think I would just say take advantage of what we've posted out on our website. If you go to our main www.pinellascounty.org/emergency page, you're going to find a link there to the El Nino page that we've prepared. And in that, we've consolidated information on the weather alert radios, information about sandbags and what we'll be doing or prepared to do for sandbag operations if flooding, localized flooding, becomes an issue. So it's a nice place where all that information is consolidated together. And the last thing I would mention is on our main page, there's a stay connected feature. So there's other ways to receive information, not just during emergencies. So our newsletter and items like that, that'll keep you posted on these type of events when we know about them and are putting the word out.
All right. Thank you both for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And as Sally said, if you'd like more information about preparing for El Nino, visit Pinellas County's El Nino website at pinellascounty.org/emergency/ L, that's the letters EL-Nino, NINO.HTM. And you can also visit Pinellas County Emergency Management's website at pinellascounty.org/emergency. And if you'd like more information about the El Nino phenomenon and other weather topics, visit the National Weather Service's website at weather.gov/Tampa Bay.